adventure. Adventure is just getting out there and figuring things out as they come up. How to pack, how to organize, where to pack, where to stay. Just you, Mother Nature, sanctity, being peaceful, quiet, all the sights and sounds. It's one of those things I think a lot of people take for granted. Traveling to new places, cutting your own path through life, flying by the seat of your pants, taking risks, calculated risks, uncalculated risks, just the whole journey along the way itself. Yeah, it's adventure. I'm Thomas Turner from Canton, Georgia.
I race professional cross country and cyclocross for Jamis Bicycles. I'm also a mechanic full-time at a local bike shop.
And living a dream. Cycling is a huge part of my life. It's a great way to see and experience a whole lot of stuff all at once. You don't get that same kind of perspective if you're touring in a car on a motorcycle. It's a lot more intimate one-on-one when you're doing it on a bike. I think it's very rewarding. It's a great, healthy lifestyle. You go 50, 100 miles, it's just an amazing experience, and you feel like you've really earned that day. When you set up camp and get to kind of sit back and relax, it makes it that much better, you know, the reward for what your hard effort you put in. I really enjoy spending my time outdoors, camping outside in the country, shooting the bow, shooting shotguns, a little bit of everything. You know, if I'm not out cycling or hunting or camping, enjoy tinkering on things. I've got an old project car in the basement. Really like working with my hands. Really like the outdoors. When it's the growing season, I enjoy gardening. I like to grow a bunch of different things. Fruit such as cantaloupes, watermelons, tomatoes, love peppers, hotter the better. All different vegetables like my squashes. I tried some new ones, they're called patty pans. They look kind of like a flying saucer. I was constantly getting plagued by deer and having to chase them out of my garden. So then I wound up having to put up these quick poles and string up horse barrier tape. And I figured for sure that would be enough to keep them out. But so far, so good. We'll see. And in the fall, I'll start tilling food plots. Planting some clover, wheat, buckwheat. Enjoy doing that. And in the winter time, when nothing's really growing, it's hunting season.
Vaporized him.
I like to get out with my bow, do some bow practice. Now if a squirrel runs out and I shoot it, you'll have to eat it. So hopefully you get something. Some real healthy lifestyle living off the land. You get really good quality meat. Combine that with the good stuff from the gardens. It's hard to beat that.
When I caught her, we were all going over to my sister's house for Easter Sunday dinner. And at first I saw something cross the road in front of me and I thought it was a wild hog. And I hopped out of the passenger seat, went up to her, and it was a pot-bellied pig. And I thought, oh man, I gotta catch her. So I cranked up my MG and scooped her up and put her in my car. And as I was racking it through the gears, she started getting more and more rambunctious. And finally, she gets up where she's coming up under the floorboard, up onto the passenger seat. And so I'm trying to push her head down, and she's trying to come up, and I'm trying to drive a manual and go through an intersection, and my dog's in the passenger seat. She's bucking her head up. She busts my knuckles under the dash, and so I'm cutting, bleeding. It's hot as hell. Oh, man, I was mad at that pig. Then when I got her out of the car, she was squealing and carrying on, and everybody came out to see what the ruckus was, because it sounded like somebody was killing a pig. But then once she kind of settled down after getting out of the car, she was actually really happy. She came in the house, hung out with everybody, wound up spending the night at my sister's house, and then she's stayed here ever since. So anyways, that's the story of Cadbury. Easter pig. She's grown up fat too, man. I don't think you'd fit in the MG anymore. I don't think I'd pick you up. Yep.
Renegade to me, it's one bike that does it all, and it does it amazingly well. Whether I'm commuting, bike packing, road riding, gravel grinding on all backcountry roads, super versatile. Just swap out some tires, mount on some racks, and you're good to go. Every mounting point you can imagine, I can move a bottle cage around, carry a couple bottles with me. You can throw some fenders on there, throw a rack on it, and go for a commute. Super fast, very efficient, stiff, lightweight frame, through axles, front and rear, huge bottom bracket area, super comfortable. You know, you can spend all day in the saddle, 20, 50, 100, 200 miles, you're not gonna get tired. Instead of having four different bikes, it's really all I need. Just a great, amazing bike.